We want to find the point in the first quadrant where the line y equals 2x intersects a circle with radius 4 centered at the origin. Let's begin by determining the equation of the circle. Well, if the equation of the circle is in this form here, h comma k would be the center and r would be the radius. So because our circle is centered at the origin, where the origin has coordinates 0 comma 0, notice in our case, both h and k are equal to 0, and the radius is 4, so r equals 4. So if both h and k are 0, this would just be x squared plus y squared equals 4 squared, or 16. That would be the equation of the circle. And the equation of the line is y equals 2x. So to find the point of intersection in the first quadrant, we'll solve this as a system of equations. But before we do this, let's look at the graph of the circle and the line. Notice how the circle is centered at the origin with a radius of 4, giving us the equation x squared plus y squared equals 16. And the given linear equation was y equals 2x. So notice how the y-intercept of this line is 0 here. And because the slope is 2, or 2 over 1, notice if we go up 2 and right 1, we find another point on the line. And because we're looking for the point of intersection in the first quadrant, we're looking for this point here. So going back to our system of equations, let's solve this using substitution, where if y equals 2x, we'll substitute 2x for y in the first equation. This will give us an equation with just x. We would have x squared plus, instead of y squared, we'd have 2x squared equals 16. 2x to the second power would be 4x squared. So we have x squared plus 4x squared equals 16. X squared plus 4x squared, or 1x squared plus 4x squared, would be 5x squared. Isolate x squared by dividing both sides by 5. So we have x squared equals 16 fifths. Notice here, x can be both positive or negative. So now when we take the square root of both sides of the equation, we need to be sure to include a plus or minus sign on the right to obtain both solutions. So we have x equals plus or minus the square root of 16 divided by the square root of 5. But since the square root of 16 is equal to 4, we have x equals plus or minus 4 divided by square root of 5. Now because we're looking for the point in the first quadrant, we know x has to be positive. So for our purposes, we know that x can only be positive 4 divided by square root of 5. Now you may be asked to rationalize this, but we'll show that in a few moments. Right now we just found that the point of intersection in the first quadrant has an x coordinate of 4 divided by square root of 5. Now let's find the y coordinate of the point of intersection. Well, we know y must equal 2 times x, or y equals 2x. So if y equals 2x, and now we know the value of x, we can find y. Y would be equal to 2, or 2 over 1, times 4 divided by square root of 5, which would be 8 divided by square root of 5. So this would be the y coordinate of the point of intersection in the first quadrant. Now I'll show how to rationalize these coordinates and also how to get a decimal approximation. So again, we just found the x coordinate is 4 divided by square root of 5, and the y coordinate is 8 divided by square root of 5. So if we want to rationalize 4 divided by square root of 5, we'd have to multiply the numerator and denominator by square root of 5. Which would give us 4 square root of 5 divided by square root of 5 times square root of 5, which is the square root of 25, or just 5. So again, this was x. And then y, remember y is equal to 2 times x, so 2 times 1 times 4 square root of 5 over 5 would just be 8. Square root of 5 over 5. So So if we are required to rationalize the denominators of these coordinates, we would say 4 square root 5 divided by 5, comma, 8 square root 5 divided by 5. And also, just in case you are asked to round these values to, let's say, 3 decimal places, let's also show that. Of course, this would require a calculator, and it'd be easier to use these coordinates to convert to a decimal. So to convert the x-coordinate to a decimal, we would have 4 divided by, on this calculator, a second x squared brings up the square root, 5, close parenthesis, enter. Rounding to 3 decimal places, notice how the 8 in the 4th decimal place would tell us to round up. It'd be approximately 1.789. And now for the y-coordinate, we would just have 8 divided by square root 5. Notice there's a 7 in the 4th decimal place, so again we round up, this would be approximately 3.578. If we want to check this graphically, the decimal approximation would probably be the best coordinates to use. Notice how this point of intersection does look like. The x-coordinate is a little bit less than 2, and the y-coordinate is a little bit more than 3.5. So the graph does verify our work. I hope you found this explanation helpful.